sky or winter chill. If I gotta take a break, I will. But I'm gonna run right up this hill.
Guys, it's Khaki. I am 2 weeks today, or actually yesterday, from my gastric bypass. I had a gastric bypass the day before Thanksgiving. I just wanted to do a video to update on my progress and what's been going on the last couple of weeks, and especially the last week since I did my last video. I completed my full liquid diet yesterday, and I got to eat soft food, very small quantity, which I'll tell you about. By the time I was done with my full liquid diet, I was so tired of cream of chicken, cream of mushroom, cream of this, cream of that soup. I don't know that I'll ever be able to eat that again. But it really got me through. It wasn't terrible. So yesterday, I got to start eating soft foods. So the first thing that I had yesterday morning, I scrambled an egg, put a little bit of cheddar cheese on it, and chopped really finely just a smidge of turkey sausage, and scrambled an egg, and I have never been so excited to eat egg in my life. I was able to eat about half of it, which I'm going to insert a picture of the before and after on that. It was the funniest thing. It's such a small amount of food, but I did like I was advised to do. I took very small bites. I, at the very first twinge of being a little bit full or maybe a little bit nauseous, I stopped and I wasn't hungry anymore. It was an amazing thing. Then at lunch yesterday, I had some tuna salad. I am very glad to be able to eat anything at this point. But let me show you a couple things that I do have. I got these plates off of Amazon. They're just little inexpensive plastic plates. They're, as you can see, about the size of a coffee saucer. And then I also got little baby forks and spoons. It says to eat about the size of a black bean or your pinky fingernail at one time. On a regular sized fork or spoon, that looks ridiculous. And, you know, a lot of what we eat is visual. So having those small utensils and plate, you know, really kind of tricks your eye, I think. It doesn't look like, oh my gosh, I've got this little smear of food on this big plate. The other thing I got, which I don't have to show you, is little 2 ounce plastic containers with tops on it. As I said, yesterday morning I had the scrambled egg. At lunch, I had some tuna salad, one pack of tuna, like the little foil pouches, made for 2 meals, 2 little containers. And I wasn't able to eat even that little 2 ounce container at one time. Left a couple of bites. And normally, you know, that's kind of a victory in itself, because normally I would have kept eating until it was gone. Got to the point where I had a couple of bites left and I thought, I need to stop. And I did. So I was very proud of myself for recognizing that, because I've always been somebody who just, if it was there, I ate it. So then last evening, I made some crab salad. I got some of the imitation crab, chopped it up really fine, put very finely chopped just a smidge of green onion and some Old Bay seasoning, a little sprinkle of dill and some mayonnaise, and was able to, from like one of the little packages at Walmart, was able to, with half of that, maybe make 4 different servings of the crab salad. So I've got that. And then this morning I had some egg salad with diced hard-boiled egg and mayonnaise and no sugar added sweet relish. I've also had today at lunch, I had some refried beans with a little bit of cheddar cheese and some non-fat, non-flavor Greek yogurt instead of sour cream. Ooh, that was good. That was really good. So I'm, you know, kind of looking forward to trying different soft things in the next couple of weeks. I'll be on that soft puree stage for a couple of weeks before I can move on to stuff with more texture. I think I've been doing really, really good. Haven't had any pain to speak of. The last area, I talked about my last video, still having a little bit of abdominal discomfort at the sutures. Haven't had that. Of course, I poke on them, you know, they'll hurt. But the very last area that was still tender was that left upper incision. And it's funny when you stop and think about all the things you use your left side for. So it didn't hurt until I was pulling on stuff. One of the things that was the most hard for me to do is close the car door when you're driving and you get in and you reach to close that car door. That was uncomfortable. I even got a grabber, pulled it open with that the first few days after my last video when I thought of doing that. Now I can do it without pain. So I think that's really good. All my incisions look really good. Everything's going well on that front. Haven't had to take any pain medicine. Am having still some back pain. And not anything debilitating or that's keeping me from doing anything. But again, I don't know if it is not having the anti-inflammatory that I used to take on a daily basis or if it's something related to the surgery. But that seems to be getting better as well. So I'm hoping that as I am able to get more active and stretch more, that that will take care of it because that usually is the case anytime I've had significant back pain in the past. The other thing that I'm so proud of, I think that I'm sleeping better. You know, I think anybody who is obese knows what I mean when you feel like you lay down and you're just like, ugh, have this all this weight on you, and you just, I don't know, it just kind of feels like you've got a heavy blanket on you almost, or you're suffocating. And I do have sleep apnea, although it was diagnosed as a mild case. And my sleep doctor, when I talked to him and told him I was going to be getting gastric bypass, he said, you know, you're not to the point that I'm concerned about you not having a BiPAP or a CPAP. He said, let's just wait. See, I feel like this will resolve with your surgery, so let's wait and see. And I'm not snoring like I was. I'm sure I am a little bit, but I'm not waking myself up snoring. Been sleeping much, much better. Very, very glad for that. It's, you know, when you get to the point that you can't even sleep comfortably, that's when you really know it's time to make a change. So, another thing, getting back to the eating, that has been a little bit hard, and I didn't really think it would be this way. Of course, I'm just 2 days into actually eating, but the whole not drinking with food is really. It's hard, and I've never been a big fluid drinker while I was eating, but just not being able to do it, I think, is very, you know, it's hard to remember that. And I had to set my cup somewhere else so I wouldn't do it involuntarily or, you know, unmindfully. So that's actually a little more challenging than I thought it was going to be. And then you get done eating and you've got the taste of the food in your mouth, and that's normally a big draw to take a sip of a drink. So when I have eaten, I've immediately brushed my teeth, and that kind of took away that urge to drink something for a little while. So that's helped. The other thing that I've really had to focus on was speed. I was going to say being in the profession or being, you know, in the work environment I am, you've always tried to shovel it in to get back to work. I think that's everybody. I think that's every job. You have a limited time. So I've really had to, I actually set a timer on my phone to make sure it took me 20 minutes to eat and that I spaced out those bites a minute or a minute and a half. And it's funny because by the time you get done eating, your food is cold. But I guess that's when you know you've taken long enough. So that's definitely something, especially as I begin eating more, that I'm going to have to focus on is slowing down and, you know, chewing really well. And the chewing's not that hard, but the speed is. You see this tiny little container of food, and normally that would have been a couple of big bites, and now it's your meal, and you've got to take these little tiny bites to finish it off. So that's kind of been a little challenge. So I did have my follow-up today, my 2 week surgical follow-up with both the dietitian and the nurse. I think she's actually a PA to my surgeon, and they were both very pleased with my progress. According to my scale at home, from the time that I started the liquid diet, the morning I started the liquid diet, to today, I've lost 30 pounds. And that just blows my mind. It doesn't seem real. You know, it's kind of that dysmorphia that it just doesn't seem like it's possible. From the time that I had my last weigh-in at my surgeon, and that day I had been on the liquid diet for like 4 days, so I'd already lost some weight. But from that day till today at my surgeon's office, I was down 25 pounds. And, you know, my PA and the dietitian both cautioned me not to be surprised if I have a pretty significant stall, because I am, you know, I have lost a pretty good amount of weight very quickly. And your body's got to kind of say, whoa, wait a minute, and just not be surprised or beat myself up or think it's anything I'm doing when that happens. So it felt good to hear that. I am noticing that my clothes are fitting different. I put on a dress. I'm still wearing dresses because pants kind of rub those incision places, but I put on a dress this weekend that the sleeves were so snug it was uncomfortable to wear last month, and it fit great. Those sleeves, you know, were a little bit loose even, so that was fabulous. That really, you know, it really brings home that you're doing something for yourself and it's working. And it's hard to trust the process. I mean, I've always been somebody who got online and researched and read and, you know, questioned everything. And it's almost scary to think that you're being successful. So I am very, you know, very glad for that. So the next week or two, I will, well, actually for 2 weeks, I will be on that pureed soft diet. After that, I can start adding in things like deli meat, cheese, a few more vegetables, still cook soft. But I've got 2 weeks before that, so I'm very happy with the way things are going. So, you know, if you're watching this and you've had gastric bypass, tell me about how that transition from your full liquids to soft and then eventually, or soft puree, then eventually more soft foods. If you want to share that would really be great to read other people's experiences. So anyway, I just wanted to give an update, and I hope everybody is doing well. And thank you so much for all the well wishes that I've gotten. And I will see you soon. I plan on updating in about a week. Thank you.